Hi, I'm Stu Clark, a program manager on the Microsoft 365 security team, and I want to give you a quick tour of using the API that Microsoft Secure Score offers. If you watched the video where I gave you a tour of the Microsoft Secure Score API, you might remember that we created a JSON using that API. Let's look at how we can now read that data in Power BI and some of the reports that we can create. So the first thing we want to do is obviously open up Power BI. So here we are. Power BI gives you numerous options for getting data. So if you've taken the option to not take the data into JSON, but you've put it into a local SQL implementation, you can use that. But for this purposes, we are going to be using the JSON file. So we just go to Get Data, we click on More. When the dialog comes up, we'll see an option in here for JSON. All we do now is press Connect, and we select the file that we exported when we did our API in the previous video. As you can see here, SecureScoreData.json. We then open this file. Now, one of the things we need to do is actually we need to do some data transformation, because obviously the data has come back in JSON format. So we need to do some tweaking to let Power BI know how we want certain columns to be structured in order to apply the report views that we wish to do. So we're just waiting for the data model to be created, and we're then going to go in and edit the query itself. So in the query itself, we can now see we have the root of our JSON file in here. The first thing we need to do is convert this into a table. It's very simple. We just select that first list and we convert to table. Power BI will now extract all of the columns within the JSON file so that we can start to do them. We need to keep expanding the columns until we've gone through the data within the JSON to the appropriate level. So we just keep clicking this separator icon here until we get to the desired level. Power BI will tell us when we're there. So as you can see, the data from Secure Score is now starting to appear as we walk through the JSON structure. And so now we're getting closer and closer. So we can start to see things like the licensed user count, our active user count, and what the actual Secure Score is. Now, because of the way that JSON holds its data, we do still need to expand some of these out. So the first thing I want to do is expand out the date. So again, within this particular column, we have year, month, and day, which we obviously need, so we expand those out. Now, what we want to do on these columns is we want to merge that into a single date column. So we just select Merge Columns. We select a separator. We were just going to use comma for this example. And we click OK. And that now takes that into a single column that we can use. Important tip, Power BI is very sensitive about the column type. So we need to make sure that we specify that this is going to be a date column. As you can now see, it has moved across into that correct format. It's also worth renaming your columns into something that's relevant so you can understand exactly what data you're working with. So we now have our tenant ID and we have the date data plus the relevant data for a particular day. One other final thing we can do, as I mentioned in the API, we get a lot more data come back through the API than we can through the score analyzer. And this is held in this control scores list here. So if we look within this list itself, we can actually start to expand those out and start to see the actual detail within. So again, we go through the same exercise. We split this column out, we expand it to a new row. Now we have expanded out the controls, we have one more step that we need to take. And again, this is a crucial one to take, as I mentioned. Power BI needs to know the column types. So by default, as you can see, it's classing the scores as a string. So what we need to do is again tell Power BI that these are actually numeric strings that we want. So for every numeric representation, we just want to make sure that we convert that column type into an actual numeric. So again, we just select the ones that we're interested in. Once we have them all, we go to the transform column, data type, and we just change to a decimal, so it's classed as a numeric number. And this becomes important if we want to kind of do any arithmetic on the controls when we're further into the process, such as we want to know the average or the median of the figures that we're going through. So now we have done this, we literally click on Close and Apply, and we're now taken back to the Power BI dashboard. Now this is where we start to model our data to the graphics that we're interested in viewing. So how do we start doing that? So the first thing we have to do is kind of pick our visualization. A really nice, easy way to show this is to kind of replicate what Secure Score gives you on the Analyzer tab. So we can select a line chart, we can expand that canvas out, and we then basically start to drag and drop the data that we're interested in showing on this particular visualization. So for this one, for my axis, I'm going to have the date. The date lets you select several hierarchies. You can look at year, you can look at quarter, you can look at month. Typically though, you're best just picking the date range itself to give you the view of the number of days that you took in through the API. We can then start to add in the various components. So let's take a look here. So we can add in our secure score. Now, as we can see, we start to get the view that the dashboard analyzer gives you. So we want to make sure again that it's not doing any additions. So we just want to take the minimum score. And here we can see this is this particular tenant's secure score trend of that 30 days worth of data that we brought back in. Now, I may be curious as to know as what's causing these rises and troughs in the environment. So we can bring back some of the categories. So we can bring back account score. So account score is basically all of the controls that fall underneath that filter of account, as we demonstrated in an earlier video. So we can then start to see how did my scores and controls that fell under the account bracket start to influence my overall secure score. So as we can see here, there was a rise in the number of points that we gave for controls in the account category, and we can see the corresponding rise in secure score, the average score over time. And we then start to bring in, okay, what else are we interested in here? What else could have influenced this particular score? So we can take data. Let's add data into here and see how that influences. So again, we can now see that data again, there was an uptick in data that starts to influence your overall secure score. Now, the granularity of this, you can really kind of take to the next level. You can start to build out very specific visualizations of what actual controls within a category are influencing your score in the most aggressive way. I've created a pre-sample of this using the exact same data set, which I'm just going to show to you now to kind of give you an idea of how those visualizations look. So this is the exact same graph we've just created. We've just made the lines a bit bolder so it's easier for you to see. The beauty we have in Power BI is that hovering over any data point, we show you what particular controls were happening on a day. Where the power of this really starts to come in is when we start to add in all of the individual controls. So it's a bit hard to see on this screen here, but basically this is every single control that SecureScore is offering. And what is the weighting that this particular control is giving to your overall secure score? So if we look at this itself, by default, I have all of my secure score controls in here. Now I can start to filter these out. So as you can see here in this list, I have things like admin MFA. So if I'm only interested in selecting a few controls that I'm interested in to see how that was influencing, I can pick admin MFA. So here I can see just the trend of the admin MFA control and how its points raised and fell over a period of time. I could add in the block transport rules, and it would now start to show me what was the movement of that particular control over this specific period of time. I can go through and add as many as I want, allowing me to see how individual controls can influence your overall score. This is great for taking back to senior leadership teams to show them how the score is being influenced within certain areas of your business. It's also great to see why a certain control is moving. If you've had a certain level of MFA points for a particular time and you notice through the visualization there's been a significant drop, it's something that you really want to go and investigate further. So we've really just scratched the surface of what you can do within Power BI. There are many visualizations from donuts to flowcharts to funnels that can give you some fantastic views of how you can manipulate the data and improve your overall security posture. So that's just a few examples of how you can use the data from the API to do your advanced reporting and increase your security position. Check out our other videos that give you a quick tour of the Microsoft Secure Score dashboard, how you can see your score progressing over time, and how to use the SecureScore API. Thanks for watching.